whole life in Joburg. Born here, raised here, lived here. The two neighborhoods that I've lived in are no more than 10 kilometers away from each other. My last move was three doors down. I love Joburg. I love it here. Like the vibe, the energy, the aggressive kind of nature to it. I love Joburg. I love that it's a bit grimy and a bit scummy and all of those things. Like, you know, people are racing to get out of Joburg because they don't like it. But for me, I really do like it. If you've known me for any amount of time, you've probably heard me say that I like Cape Town as a friend. I love going there, but I love coming home. Other thing you've probably heard me say is that Joburg is a cesspool, but it's my cesspool. And that's really how I feel. Like, my eyes aren't closed to what Joburg's like, but I like it anyway. For years, people have been telling me to come down to Cape Town. You gotta come down to Cape Town, you gotta move to Cape Town. Honestly, like, it's always sounded ridiculous to me. I've always just thought, like, that's ridiculous. Why would you wanna live in Cape Town? Why would I wanna live there? Like, I go there on holiday, it's great, but I don't wanna live there. Which is why it's so strange that I'm moving to Cape Town next month. Over the last year and a half, I've undergone a pretty dramatic transformation personally. Mentally, most importantly, physically, yes. Lost 14 kgs. Changed my lifestyle from a completely sedentary one to one where I'm moving every single day, even doing a little bit of exercising and gym. I'm eating right. But the big change has been mentally. So I've suffered from depression probably my whole life and been medicated for about 12, 13 years of that, maybe a bit more even. Medication's amazing. It kept me alive, honestly. It really did. But I think my particular thing is that I was kind of letting the medication do the heavy lifting while actively fighting against it with my thoughts, with my thought life, my thought habits, my patterns of thinking and talking to myself, that sort of thing. I didn't realize how intensely negative my self-talk was in the last year and a half, been working with an incredible counselor and coach. And he's been coaching me and just helping me see where I need to tweak the way I think about life and think about myself. The big shock, the big revelation for me was just how absolutely unfair, unkind, harsh, and false my beliefs were about myself. And he saw it immediately and started to call me out on it and say, like, hang on, this thing that you just said, you just described yourself in this way, is that fair? Is that kind? Is that accurate? Most of the time, it wasn't. And so putting some mental rules in place of like, no, hang on, if you're thinking something about yourself, first evaluate, you know, is it accurate? Is it kind? You know, is it fair? Just putting that little sort of backstop in place to say, no, hang on, before you think something about yourself or about your situation or about your life, just first just evaluate whether it's even true or not. And if it isn't, you need to reject it from yourself and not allow yourself to do that to yourself. I read something once that said, if you had a friend that spoke to you the way you speak to yourself, would you be friends with that person? The answer for me was absolutely not. Like, I don't let people speak to me like that at all. They're gone. They're absolutely gone. The worst one of all was inside the walls. I was hiding inside the walls. All that to say, I've been off antidepressants for 4 months now, and I feel amazing. I feel more positive about my life than I ever have. I feel more positive about myself than I ever have. I've got a more grounded and stable and fair view of myself. It's funny, the change has been so remarkable and I didn't kind of notice it originally, but my close friend group, they started calling me Ash 2.0 just because the change was so drastic and so noticeable. I've had people ask me, are you taller? It's kind of hilarious to me, but it's about the way I feel about myself has actually changed the way I walk. It's changed the way I stand. It's changed the way I am in the world. That's crazy. It's absolutely crazy. Like a few little mental habits and a few little physical habits and your life is entirely different. I'm not sure why I'm moving to Cape Town. The simplest answer I can give is that that's where the next episode is. So the actual story, it kind of happened like this. Family, friends of my mother invited her to go and live down in Cape Town with them. She knows my stock answer about Cape Town. I like it as a friend. No way, is not going to live there. She knows that. And so we're having a quick catch-up call. And so she says to me, very offhanded, kind of towards the end of the conversation, she says, so you're moving to Cape Town with me? And the second she said it, for some reason, I didn't give the stock answer of you're nuts. Something just felt right. As she said it, I thought, you know, that's a good idea. And so what I said to her is, let me think about that. And she said, oh no. Because she was expecting me to just kind of write it off and then she could stop thinking about it and just go like, nah. But for some reason, it just clicked and felt right. And I thought, this is something to think about. And so I started to pray about it, started to think about it. And the only thing that I could get from this decision was absolute peace. I think this is where the next episode is. This is where the next step is. That's where the next chapter is. That's where the next part of the story happens. And I've not felt anxious about the move. I've not felt worried. I didn't even get a full day to worry about the fact that this was going to cost a lot of money. It didn't even enter my mind. It kind of dawned on me. I was like, this is going to cost quite a bit of money. And obviously I want to help with my mother's expenses as well. So I'm like, so we need two deposits for rent. We need to move two homes across country. We need to move two cars. We need to move four pets. This is going to cost quite a bit of money. I didn't even have a chance to worry about it. And I got phone calls, just random out of the blue phone calls. I need this big job. I need this big job. I need this big job. Before I even had a chance to worry about it, it was paid for. The entire move was paid for. The property in Cape Town goes insanely fast. Like you see an apartment that looks amazing, you message them, it's been up for 3 hours and they're like, sorry, it's taken already, you know? So that was a potential thing to worry about. So I decided, let me go down to Cape Town for a week and I'll just see a bunch of agents and try and secure a place for later in the year or something like that, you know? This is my thinking. So I arranged a few appointments and then booked the flights, went down there. Because it's the middle of like Easter holidays, the flights skyrocketed in price, so I couldn't get the exact time frame that I wanted, so I had to cut it short and put it over a weekend, which wasn't really ideal. So now I've got a short trip, I've got a 3-day trip. One of those days is a Sunday, and apparently estate agents don't work on Sundays in Cape Town. So I've got these essentially 2 days to find these two apartments, and every place you call they're just like, no pets, or sorry, it's already taken. Family friends down there were just absolute godsends. They were so good at taking me around, showing me places, saying this is what a bad area looks like in Cape Town, because it looks very different from a bad area in Joburg. Let me tell you taking me around, showing me where to go, taking me to viewings. It was incredible. But on Saturday, those appointments kind of either fell through or were just okay or not so good, that kind of thing. Then Sunday, no one's available to do anything. Everyone's sitting on the beach, I guess. Monday, I look at a place that seemed pretty promising. So I said, okay, I'd like that one. So now we wait and see. Then I'm still looking for one more apartment for my mother. I'm flying out of Cape Town at 3 o'clock and we're doing a viewing at 12 still, I think it was, 12 o'clock. And that one was perfect. This little trip should have been just an anxiety ridden nightmare, because each one I looked at was kind of another no. And I'm like, well, now I can't find, I'm like searching through private property, this sort of thing. Family, friends are looking through places, sending me places. Friends are sending me places. Did you see this place? Looking at them, they're falling through. It should have been causing so much anxiety in me. The only thing I felt was peace. I'm like, we've got it. It's fine. It's going to work out. I saw a place. It was perfect for my mother. And they said, but somebody's already put their application in. And I was like, it's fine. Send me the application forms because I'll get it. There was such an assurance that, you know, like God's got my back. I must have sounded like a crazy person because she's like, well, an application's already in on that unit. So I'm like, send me the forms. I'll get it. They're not going to get it. So I filled in the forms and sent them. And she's like, yeah, I'll get to your application tomorrow, you know, after I've done theirs. And we got it. Sorry, those other guys. It was ours. I had that experience with both of the units that I found. Like, just walked in, I was like, yep, this is mine, this is great, it's sorted out. Such a piece about the whole thing. The big shock has been the timeline. I was kind of thinking last half of the year. I was thinking, yeah, like mosey on down there, 6 months time or 9 months time and whatever, you know, like it's fine, I'll get down there. When I realized how fast property goes, and how you kind of don't really have a lot of leeway and a lot of options, I realized you kind of have to just jump, you know, you kind of have to do this thing. So hence the sudden departure, the sudden move. It's kind of been a month in discussion now, maybe a little more than a month, but not more than two. So from going from honestly believing with all my heart 3 months ago even that I would end my life in Joburg, I would finish out the rest of my life in Joburg, I would have bet my life on that. I would have bet anything on that fact. It was a fact. To now, in 30 days time, I'm gonna be living in Cape Town, 5 minute walk from the beach. I can't believe it. It's crazy. It's crazy. Wake up, this is Joburg. Not for much longer. So that's the story of Ash 2.0 and the next episode. I guess the next vlog will be from the beach. See you guys there.
Took you long enough.